Kia ora nā tātou kātoa toa mā loelelei and welcome to this Tagata Pasifika special. I'm John Pulu.
Kia ora nā tālo for lover everybody. I'm Ernestina Bonsu Maro. Kia ora nā JP.
Kia ora nā.
Today we're here to bring you highlights of this year's New Zealand Te Maeva Nui Festival.
That's right, we're at the Trust Stadium here in West Auckland and it's the third time this festival's been held like this in Aotearoa.
It kicks off tonight with the Tūrangatira Awards, followed by a two-day festival of Cook Island song and dance.
But before that, let's take a look at the journey so far. The first Te Maeva Nui was held in 2019. Then 2 years later in 2021. Now the 2023 version promises to be bigger and better, but the challenges remain.
It's been hard because we have more groups this time, and the groups have expanded from 120 to 150. So, you know, more people come in, more problems, you know, but we love it.
I still don't congratulate Noah for his strength to carry on and his courage. And he's got a very small band of people beside him, and they're making it happen.
Te Maeva Nui is run by the Te Maeva Nui o Aotearoa New Zealand Charitable Trust. It's a small team responsible for such a huge undertaking.
When you look at it, there's only four of us in the board. That's a very small board for such a big event. And people sort of look at us and say, how can you guys actually do that? Well, it comes down to trusting each other, learning from each other, and making sure that we can compromise, because nobody's right all the time. So sometimes you have to compromise with your board members and come to some sort of resolution that everyone agrees to. But it's good.
As in previous years, board members visited teams during rehearsals and were impressed by what they saw.
Now, I'm just so proud of the way we have visited all the dance teams. It's great. It just warms your heart. This is our tamariki, learning our cultures, singing our songs, and doing the pe'e dancing. Oh my gosh, it's just so uplifting.
We felt each group that we go see are different. People are more dedicated now than the last two Te Maeva Nuis. I think they're a lot more faith in Te Maeva Nui now. And you know, when you have faith in something, you work harder, you know, because you believe in it, you know. You know what I mean.
One of the board's aims is to foster Cook Island's language and culture, especially among the New Zealand-born.
The only way you can learn your culture and who you are, come and join any of our teams. And we're hoping next Maeva Nui will be big, because it's just a boost to our young people. I think the winner is our youth. When we went out to visit all the different islands, that was what came through.
Wow, okay, so we know that Te Maeva Nui or Aotearoa Charitable Trust organises the event, and we know that language and culture is one of the main drivers behind it.
Yes, but wait, that's not all. The whole thing kicks off with the Tūrangatira Awards, a night reserved especially for those from this community who have excelled in business, the community and the arts.
Having this Tūrangatira Awards is a way of recognising some of the achievements within our communities. Otherwise, outside our community, they would never have this opportunity. And this time here, I've noticed that the achievements of some of our recipients are actually quite high.
Special guests from the awards included dignitaries from the islands, as well as local MPs like Labour's Carmel Sepuloni.
The Cook Islands has a very special and unique relationship with New Zealand, Aotearoa, and so brings so much vibrancy to this country, but also has a connection that is very unique and very special.
Among award recipients on the night was Sports Award winner Junior Te Ariki Manapori, who was in esteemed company.
Oh, it's a privilege to be given this opportunity to be even be a finalist with the talented nominees also here as well. And for me, it was about representing my island, my nation, and just doing something that I'm passionate about.
Yeah, I really love seeing other Cook Island people excel, whatever areas that is, sports, all of that. I feel like there's a lot of talent in the Cook Islands, and yeah, they can achieve whatever they want to achieve.
And many of the award winners came from all over Aotearoa.
I feel very honoured, I feel very proud to be recognised here tonight in front of our people, but also very proud that I got to represent Porirua, my community from Porirua. Thank you guys for always supporting me. Probably wouldn't have come, been here without the constant support of my work and I get to do what I love as well.
When I was nominated, it was the biggest shock. But also it was like the biggest heartfelt hug. Coming from Christchurch, there's very few of us. And so to be here in Auckland and to celebrate with everybody is like, whoa. Cook Islanders, even the deep south, can go everywhere.
For many here, the awards is recognition for many hours of toil behind the scenes.
I feel like it's super important. Like, we go day to day without any sort of recognition ever, and we do so much. So this is, in the scope of things, something so little but so big. Not just for ourselves, but for our community, for our villages that we come from, and for all the people that back us.
It's such an amazing event, actually, to acknowledge those who are working hard for our small little nation in their own corners. Whether it's on social media or behind the scenes, everyone gets acknowledged. And that's what I love about our awards night tonight.
Well, there you have it. Congratulations to all our Tūrangatira Award winners this year.
Well done, guys. When we come back, on with the show. Kia ora ana, welcome back to Tagata Pasifika and our highlights of the Cook Islands community's Te Maeva Nui Festival here in West Auckland.
10 groups are on show over 2 days and each group has to perform 5 items. This year's theme is Te Oranga Kereti Ano I Roto I Te Matakei Nanga, our stories of Christianity narrated throughout our community.
2023 is a significant year in the history of the Cook Islands. 200 years ago, the gospel arrived on Rarotonga and the nearby islands of Ngāpūtoru, before spreading to the rest of the group over the following years.
It's a special year next year, 2024, for Auauenua Malaya. 200 years since we accepted the gospel, since our Ariki Numangatini accepted the gospel. So it was only right and easy, actually, to make sure that all of our themes were based on the decision and the sacrifice that our Ariki made of Numangatini. So I've only been learning through the items on how our people were enhanced and saved because of it. So when you see the results, you can't really deny the vehicle that got the results for our people, which is our faith.
There's a line in our history, Kare Mauwake. It talks about how the wounds that have been cut by our enemies have not even healed yet you come again and again. And that sentence resonated with me. So I wanted to create a pair where we told that story and how the arrival of Christianity came to Mitiaro and we were able to see peace through that arrival.
Sometimes composers and choreographers and tutors, they fully go for the full, this is Christianity, this is how it arrived, and this is what happened in our home. But I wanted to take upon a different perspective and a different lens of Christianity, just touch basing on things of how colonization came along and how Christianity was a part of that. The challenging one was the pe'e, because pe'e doesn't always have to be angry, war. It can solely mean you telling a story and portraying a story as well.
Thank you.
Represent my village, obviously. I'm coming from Waipai and just being a New Zealand-born Cook Islander. But yeah, just really excited to showcase what we've been doing for the last 6 months.
It's actually like something good for us because not many of us know our roots, and just tracing that back through performing arts is like a huge thing for us.
All throughout the weeks, it's been stressful with everything, but we're finally here, so we're giving our best.
We just hope we can show a part of Lukuro, what we're about, and just all the hard work that we've come together and fought through these past months.
Talo Falava, welcome back to our Te Maeva Nui special and this celebration of Cook Islands culture.
Yes, now this is the third time it's been held in its present format here in Aotearoa. The competition includes islands communities taking part for the very first time.
That's right, and one of those is the team from Nukuroa.
The team from Nukuroa hail from the island of Mitiaro in the southern Cook Islands, and this year they have the service of talented choreographer Maggie Anitilea.
I'll be honest, I think because this is the first time for Nukuroa, they've been waiting for the opportunity. And so as soon as they heard that we were having a presentation day, we had a full house. So to be able to select a few really great leaders amongst us, it was easy. They're very, very hearty people, very proud. I think it was quite easy to be able to share what we can do. Being involved in Te Maeva Nui for years in some sort of field.
Among the Nukuroa group are brother and sister duo, whose mother hails from Mitiaro. For them, it's been an emotional journey.
I'm here for my mum. I'm here to be an expression that everything she did for us wasn't wasted, wasn't taken for granted. Here for the things that she was passionate about, that she loved, her people, my people. That's why I am. That's why I joined.
Performances last night, I really didn't know how it was going to go, but the whole thing, I was so excited. It was joyful, you know? It was so good to be a part of something like this. And it's just been, the people have really made this journey. It has been amazing, the best thing I have ever done.
For many others, though, it's been a journey to remember.
A large part of me is really sad that it's coming to an end, especially for myself as a non-Cook Islander, to be able to have been embraced in this journey is what makes me, I think, really passionate about learning more about the Cook Island culture.
Give it a go. You'll meet new friends, you'll meet new family, and you'll learn a new culture like I have, and this is good. It's good fun.
Bye.
I just moved here recently, so I'm glad that I got the opportunity to join the Te Maeva Nui here in New Zealand.
This is my first Te Maeva Nui, so it's good to represent our town and just proud tonight.
One thing that I've learned is that no matter the challenges that you face in your life, you'll get through them.
It's actually quite exciting, eh? It was quite a long road, long journey, but it was really good to see everyone doing their bit, doing their best.
Maloilele and welcome to the Cook Islands Community Te Maeva Nui Festival. You know, a big part of this event is the time and effort that goes into making the performers look amazing on the day.
That's right, rake or costuming is a huge part of Te Maeva Nui, and each year it just seems to get better and better.
For costume makers, they get to shine a week before the Te Maeva Nui at a special pre-judging event. That way, the judges can get up close for a first-hand look at the quality and creativity.
All the teams have presented their stories to us, and so already we're excited from viewing some of the costumes so far. The stories are all explorative and historical from a cultural perspective, and we're just proud to, you know, ensure that our people get a chance to, a platform to tell their stories, our stories.
We wanted to keep things simple, take it back to basics. I think our culture is coming away from how we should dance. So it's best to not have any extras, if you like, and see how you dance without it. Our kaparima is based on our iminetuki. How has the evangelia impacted our people in the community, in our matakeinanga? And iminetuki has definitely impacted us. It's been around for years. So because of that, our iminetuki is gold. So our girls are dressed in rose gold and our boys are in yellow gold. And we've got everything simple, clean. We're trying to keep away from feathers. We do have them in there, but we just don't want to be too extra. Just keeping it simple and clean.
Maeva Nui is a huge challenge. Some groups start from the beginning of the year, and it's September now. And so because of that, there's a lot of stress. It was a beautiful challenge, understanding the theme and making sure that we're not going off theme and making sure that our costumes are created to the theme, because that's a very important aspect of costume making. The costume enhances and empowers the choreography so that when the audience is watching as well, it's really important that they get a clear point of view and a clear perspective.
So far, we're not surprised. We're very proud of our people because things aren't going well for everyone. Everyone's struggling. All the island groups are struggling. Communities are struggling. So to see the batch of costumes that have come out so far and the creativity that has exploded onto the stage is wonderful. Yes, congratulations to all the teams.
We'll be right back.
Oh, it's nervous excitement. We're really keen to do our waka proud. So, yeah, it's my first time, so really looking forward to embrace our culture.
Coming from a Samoan background, I think it's good to, and I found a passion with kokaina dancing, and I think it's good because the Nukura Inua has really brought, I think, passion, more passion out of me as well, through dance and everything.
For me personally, I'm just like sort of reconnecting with my culture. And I'm doing this with my daughter. So for me, that's my biggest influence, is to sort of share this with my kids.
Yeah, it's been pretty full on. It's hours and hours of rehearsals and lots of sacrifice, but it's been awesome to come together and meet new people and bond together as a group.
Welcome back. You know, Te Maeva Nui isn't just a celebration of song and dance. It's an important part of helping to keep our language and culture alive.
Yes, and as we heard earlier, it's one of the founding principles of the Te Maeva Nui o Aotearoa Charitable Trust, which runs this event.
The goal of Te Maeva Nui from day one has always been to sustain our reo and our culture for the New Zealand-born Cook Islanders who have no idea about why you call yourself a Cook Islander, why would you feel proud to be a Cook Islander? And I can say right now, that seeing what's happening as of tonight, I think we are like maybe over 60% with achievement of that goal, that our reo and our culture is alive here in New Zealand.
It's very important for Te Pāmi to support our children because our days are gone and the days are for our children to lead and to learn and carry on the culture. It's not hard to do it because they're eager to do it. And they just heard that Inua is there, they just come in and join. So we welcome them all. It's not hard to look. They look for the culture. They seek for it instead of us looking for them.
I joined for my culture. I don't know, I just felt the need and I loved it. And because my old Cook Island language, it was dead. And I was ashamed because no one was showing how proud they were of their culture, so that's why I stepped up. And because this is my dad's island, so guys, are you on top? Yeah.
Yeah, we don't hear our language every day. Our family connections are dispersed across a really big, big city. So to be in a group like this for this long, learning our language, learning our stories, connecting with our families. You know, the first day I was like, I don't know this person. Two questions, and oh, you're so-and-so's granddaughter. Oh, you're auntie so-and-so's daughter. And the bonds that come with that, yeah, it's a big commitment, but my gosh, it's rewarding.
Thank you. proud. I've never danced Northern style like this before. So it was nice to learn all the new techniques and everything.
I love Cook Island culture, even though I'm not Cook Island. The singing, the dancing, it just screamed to me. It was just beautiful.
It was so many late nights just rehearsing and going over and over it again. It was worth it. We put our all into that stage, and I'm glad with the performance that we came here to do.
Nisan Bulavinaka, welcome back. Te Maeva Nui takes an awful lot to organise, as well as what happens on stage. There's a host of activities which take place in and around the festival.
That's right, and making sure things go smoothly are an army of technicians, helpers, judges and volunteers who make it all happen.
It's been an amazing weekend. The weather's been crazy, but inside here, the sun's been shining. It's amazing. You know, there's so many teams here. Backstage here, you probably see there's three teams. You know, these teams have up to 80 to 100 performers on stage at one time. So just in the holding bay, we have 300 people. And then we've got another 100 on the stage.
I pretty much wear several hats. So we've got market, we've got the teams coordinating, we've got the awards night, Turangatira coordinating. But our judges as well, our sponsors that we need to take care of, make sure that they're happy always. Our customers that are coming in, so yeah, it's a huge operation that we take care of with just a few of us, and we're really grateful for our team that's come on to volunteer, to commit their time and sacrifice for our community.
There's three pillars that we'd like to make a statement on. Is first one is our Turangatira Awards. The other one is the market side, which is outside, and that's promoting an atmosphere for the entrepreneurial skills of our community to be self-sufficient. Then the other side is the cultural celebration. Majority of Cook Islanders are actually born in New Zealand. As we're further away from the source, it gets a little bit more distilled in the way that it... The hunger is greater. So serving our young at the moment with the culture and the language, preserving the language and maintaining that and giving them their pride.
I want to say me takemata to all our sponsors that have helped us and supported in the dream to create this for our people, Cook Islands community and the wider Pacific community. We're proud to say that we're here to stay, and we want to say thank you to also the Pacific community for coming out today.
Meitaki Atupaka family, let's get back to the show. Rutu te pa'u!
Thank you.
Accelerated, it was just awesome, awesome vibe from our family from Tokoroa. As you can tell, lost my voice, but we had to leave it all on the stage because that was our last one.
My heart's full, you know, it's good to be out here and represent the Cook Island culture. So initially I'm Aotearoa Māori, so to be able to get in touch with this side of Māori tanga and Te Ao Māori, it's beautiful.
And it was good, it was a fun journey, you know, because coming back to dancing, especially after being pregnant and all, it's just been like a different experience because I'm not as fit as I used to be, but I came back just to perform for my son so that he can see that we're a part of the culture, we'll always be a part of the culture. It's like bittersweet, but at the same time, it's like full circle, but like I guess kind of rewarding as well, you know, after putting so many months of training, hard work, late nights, blood, sweat and tears, everything. yeah, it was really rewarding, and it was, you know, obviously very emotional for us to finally go on stage and perform what we've been training for.
It's been really awesome actually. So it was my first Maeva Nui, it's my first time dancing. Being Cook Islander, you know, it's a little bit sad that I don't really know the culture, don't know how to dance, and so yeah, for me it's been like absolutely awesome.
You know, it's been 4 months, long hours every night, and just to finally show it, it's quite emotional, eh? I guess this is like our last 100 meters that we're doing, you know, like we got no energy, you know, back against the wall. Are we gonna give up now, or are we gonna sprint that last 100 meters? Yeah.
Our feelings this day, can't wait till it's finished. And another thing is, like, yes, everyone did a good job from the costuming to the funding to everything, and that's why we're here. And so from us to you fellas watching, boy, it took it all, 16 style coming your way.
At the Waiwolo, just some of the amazing reactions from our performers and participants this year.
Now, of course, Te Maeva Nui is a competition, so here's a wrap of the final placings.
Ladies and gentlemen, my goodness, it's been a veritable feast of the senses. It has been gorgeous to watch all of these groups representing our islands.
After 2 days of singing and dancing and a celebration song or two, it was time to share out the prizes.
You ready? The moment you've been waiting for.
Groups were given an A, B or C ranking in each dance category and collected a cash award, while three groups each scored 3 A's for their 5 items. Only one group scored 4 A's on the night, and that was Oire Tokoroa.
Oire Tokoroa!
It's very high energy, like it's a very electric feeling around being around all the other Inuas and enjoying our time together. Bring the house down, you know?
Great connection with our own people.
Yeah.
And it's really good to maintain our language and our culture.
Keep it alive.
Especially for our young people.
This is my first time ever, like, dancing, performing to my Maeva Nui. I've only ever watched it once, other than back home. And it's been so overwhelmingly awesome.
It's been a really roller coaster of a ride. A roller coaster of emotions,
stress levels.
But it's been amazing. It's been an amazing journey.
I'm tired, but also very excited. Congratulations to all the winners.
Yeah,
we are all winners at the end of the day. I'm very proud of everybody, especially shout out to our bro, Virg Ponini, who wrote our email of key, A great brother.
It was so worth it. I'm proud to be from Waipau, doing it alongside my cousin. We got A's, and this is our first time.
Three A's.
Happy day.
Well, there you have it, another Cook Islands Te Maeva Nui Festival right here in Aotearoa.
Thanks to the organisers and all groups who took part in letting us in this amazing event.
And me takemata to you, Tina. Now, don't forget to join us again next week when we return to our regular programming. And if you want to see any of our stories again or the latest Pacific news, go to tpplus.co.nz or TVNZ Plus.
Until then, have a great week, everybody, at the Waiwolo.
Kia ora ana e kia manuia.